So we've had a few interesting moments over the last week. But the reality is drivers aged between 16 to 24 are involved in almost one third of fatalities on Queensland roads. Sharon is no stranger to crashes on the road, so I thought I'd use this opportunity to look at it from a responder's point of view.
So with your 19 years experience in the crash unit, are there any crashes in particular that really stood out to you?
Yes, absolutely, and there's actually quite a few. I will say there's one very particular one involving a mobile phone, which I just recall feeling this sense of just disappointment when we realised a text message that couldn't wait.
So I guess you've got to think, when you're about to go send a text, is that, will you be able to live with the fact that your text might kill somebody?
Well, yes, but I would say there isn't a text that you need to send while you're in motion. When you think about who's in the car with you when you're driving, not a random stranger, family, parents, friends, people you love. So there's this horrific situation that families find themselves in. You have a family who is grieving the loss of a child, but now they're also facing the reality that the child was hurt in a car driven by a sibling. This is the kind of stuff that you don't recover from.
Ever since I started learning to drive, my dad's been drilling into me about how majority of the time it is a guy who crashes the car.
Statistically speaking, yeah, young male drivers aged between 17 and 24 are overrepresented as drivers involved in fatal traffic crashes. But at the same time, females in the same age category are overrepresented as the passenger.
So have you got any advice for passengers in the car that they might be scared but they don't want to seem lame or they're ruining the fun?
My advice is to think now of a strategy that you can implement if this situation arises where you're in a car and you're very uncomfortable with the way it's being driven. By diffusing that behaviour, they then will reset and go back to driving in a way that is less risky.
So have you had any close calls driving or?
Yes, and it was a very long time ago. So I was driving in a friend's car on a very windy stretch of road, taking a corner too quickly. The back end slid out and I just did not know what to do. So I did nothing. And where I stopped, I was on the wrong side of the road, facing directly into traffic. We were all very lucky. That scared me, it really scared me. But I was only 17 when that happened. But trying to pass that lesson on to my kids so they don't make the same mistakes. Every parent's hope when teaching our young people how to drive, not just be a driver, be a good driver, be a safe driver.